like what I'm going through now. Amen. But I'm still going to keep a smile on my face. Huh? Because when you think about it, God has been good to you. No matter what you're going through, no matter what you're dealing with right now, God is still a good God. I don't care if you're going through hell and high water, God still deserves the praise. And you ought to make up in your mind that no matter what I'm going through, I'm not going to let the spirit of what I'm going through kill my spirit. I'm not going to let the spirit of what I'm going through steal my joy. So in the midst of all of it, I'm still going to say, Lord, I thank you. Why, Pastor? Because it could have been the other way. Because somebody got it worse than you got it right now. I sincerely believe that there's somebody that would love to be in your shoes. Somebody that got it far worse than you could ever have it. Would do anything to change and swap with your situation. Look at the neighbor and say, don't bow to your situation. I came to tell somebody, amen, that we cannot allow the enemy, amen, the devil to rule over us. We cannot allow situations to make us desperate. Come on, say amen. We cannot allow situations to, as I said earlier, kill our spirit. We cannot allow situations to steal our joy. We cannot allow situations to take the smile off of our faces. Let's face it, we're going to have some problems. Amen. You show me a person living in this world that ain't got a problem. Amen. I show you a figment of your imagination. We all going to have problems. Come on, say amen. But the key to it is not letting the problem have you. The key to it is persevering. The key to it is going through it. How do we know? You'll never get to it if you don't go through it. You got to go through it to get to it. How you going to tell somebody what God will do if you ain't ever been through nothing? How you going to give somebody some advice when you ain't been through nothing? Can I get a witness in here? I found out sometime that God will allow us to go through, not for the sake of ourselves, but he'll allow us to go through for the sake of somebody else. He'll use us as a guinea pig. Come on, y'all. He'll use us as a guinea pig, but all the glory and all the praise will go to the Lord. I stopped by to tell somebody this morning, don't you dare allow your situation to cause you to bow. Can I get a witness in here? The word bow means to submit. Is that right? The word bow means to remove yourself. Amen. When you bow to something, you're submitting to it. When you bow to something, Jimmy's, you're giving in to it. Come on, say amen. I believe it was the late prime minister of New England, amen, Churchill, that said, never give in. Come on, somebody. And we've got to adopt that. Never give in. I don't care how bad it looked, how bleak it looked, how dark it looked, how dismal it looked. I don't care what the prognosis is from the doctor. I don't care what the pink slip said from the job. I don't care what the husband said about divorce. I came to tell somebody, never give in. Never bow down to the enemy. Especially when you know what the will of God is. Especially when you know that God didn't bring that. Amen. How many of we accept a lot of stuff that God didn't bring? How many know it ain't in the will of God? I don't have to accept it. But y'all don't like me here. Come on and say hallelujah. Look at somebody and say, don't bow to your situation. And in this particular story here, this Bible story that we're all familiar with, we remember Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego as little children. We remember this as a Bible story. In Sunday school, y'all remember Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. They were, amen, from Jerusalem, but they were brought over to, amen, the country of Babylon. And they were given Babylonian names. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego was not their Jewish name, but they were their Babylonian names. And they were taken over into Babylon. And the Bible records that while they were over in Babylon, the Babylonians wanted them to sing a Zion song. But they said, how can we sing a Zion song in a strange land? So the Bible said the Israelites hung their harps on the willows of the tree. And we find Shadrach and Meshach and Abednego. Amen. The king knew these boys because it was the same three Hebrew boys along with Daniel Daniel that was presented before the king. Amen. And the Bible declared here, amen, that the powers that be had convinced King Nebuchadnezzar to build a statue unto his image. And the Bible said the king put out a royal decree that at a certain time of a day, every man, woman, boy, and girl were supposed to bow down to this statue. When they heard the music, when they heard the trumpet, when they heard the violin, when they heard the drum, when they heard the string instruments, they were to bow down to the image. How do you know, ever since you got saved, ever since you gave Christ your life, ever since you gave the devil back his junk, the devil has been trying to get you to bow down to him. Ever since you said, for God I live and for God I die. Ever since you said, amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. Ever since you said, I once was lost, but now I'm found. I was blind, but now I see. Ever since you said, a charge to keep I have, and a God to glorify. Ever since you said, I'm a go if I got to go by myself. Ever since you said, glory, glory, hallelujah, since I laid my burdens down, the devil has been trying to get you to bow down to him. Can I get a witness in here? But I came to tell somebody that God got a man that the devil can't break, and God got some women that the devil can't break. In other words, no matter what you do to them, they refuse to bow down. Come on, somebody. You hear people say all the time, I refuse to come down to your level. I refuse to step out of my manhood. I refuse to stop being the lady that you are, to step down to your level. And that's what the devil is trying to do. He's trying to get you to bow down to his level. He's trying to tell you you're sick when you're really well. He's trying to tell you you're broke when you're really He's trying to tell you you're the tail when you're really the head. He'll try to tell you to live when you really can borrow. Can I get a witness in here? Shake a neighbor by the hand like you're going to shake it all and say, I refuse to bow down. I refuse to give in to the devil. Y'all sit down, you're making me nervous. But I refuse to bow down to the enemy. I don't care what come over the pipeline. I don't care what the enemy say. Amen. He can say what he want to say. I don't have to accept what the devil say. I better believe what God say. But I ain't got to accept what the devil say. Let me hear say, God, I preach if y'all wake up here. I heard the Bible said that once the music began to play, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were down at the farmer's market, and they noticed that at the particular time that the music started playing, they noticed that everybody went to bowing. Amen. And when everybody started bowing, it was three men standing erect. It was three men still standing up. It was three men that could be seen over the vast crowd. Come on, somebody. And somebody went back and told Nebuchadnezzar that everybody obeyed but three people. Let me hear you say, now let me throw this revelation out to you, and you got to listen closely to what I'm saying. I'm going to throw this revelation out, and then I'm going to explain it to you. But you know what the Lord is looking for? He's looking for some disobedient people. Wait a minute. Y'all didn't get that. I said the Lord is looking for some disobedient people. Wait a minute, Reverend. You mean obedient, don't you? No, I'm talking about some disobedient people. Well, what do you mean, Pastor Mitchell? The disobedient folk that won't do what the devil say, that won't obey the devil. Y'all didn't get that. Oh, yeah, when the devil said lay down, you said, uh-uh. When the devil said throw in the towel, you said, uh-uh. When the devil said shut your mouth, you said, uh-uh. When the devil said doubt God, you said, uh-uh. Hallelujah.
We've been disobedient to God. Amen. But we need to be disobedient to the devil. And the king said, look at here. These three boys won't bow. They brought them to King Nebuchadnezzar. And one thing about the king, whenever he put a law out, even he couldn't renege. When he put his signet ring on that law, when he put his seal on that law, even he couldn't take it back. Talk to me, somebody. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. The king loved them boys because he knew it was something special about them. But since his word was out, he couldn't renege. They had to go to the fire. Talk to me, somebody. Look at somebody sitting next to you and tell them, say, neighbor, sometimes you got to go to the fire. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Sometime you got to go to the fire. I know you don't want to go, but if you're living for Jesus, one day you got to go to the fire. Am I right about it? What fire are you talking about? The fire of trials and the fire of tribulation. Sometime the heat is going to get hot. Oh, yes, it is. If you don't believe me, keep living. It's going to get hot in your life. One of these days, you keep on living. Everything going to go wrong. Do I have any help in here? Somebody say it. Come on and say it. Some of y'all sitting there looking at me like you're watching TV. But just don't change the channel. But I refuse. Lord have mercy. I said, I refuse to bow down to the devil. And the king said, look at here. I done already put my signet. I done put my signature on it. And boys, as much as I love you, I can't renege. So he said, look at here. Get me some servants and take Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. And I want you to bind them up. Let them put their coats on. Let them put their hats on. Get some ropes, bind their hands, bind their feet, and put them in the furnace. But before you put them in there, cut it up. How many know the devil want to cut the fire up? Talk to me, somebody. When it rains, when it rains, it pours. If it ain't one thing, it's the same old thing. But can't nobody, Lord, I preach if they wake up. Can't nobody, I said, can't nobody do me like Jesus. He said, cut it up. Somebody say, cut it up. Open your mouth, say, cut it up. He said, cut that furnace up seven times hotter. That means he was really mad. He was really indignant. Number one, to burn up a man is a bad thing. But to cut it up seven times hotter is to add insult to injury. In other words, I really want to teach them a lesson. But the king didn't know God was going to teach him a lesson. Yeah. Talk to me, somebody. Yeah. I feel the same here. And he cut it up. I said, he cut it up. I said, he cut it up. Yeah. Seven times hotter. Yeah. Threw them in the furnace. Their hands were bowed. Their feet were swallowed. Yes, they did. But early. Yeah. I said, early. I said, early. That next morning, the king went down there to see what had happened to the boys. He looked in there. He said, wait a minute. Talk to me. Wait a minute. Talk to me. Wait a minute. He said, my eyes are playing tricks on that. Then we put three in there, but there's another one in there. He looked like the Son of God. Tell somebody, neighbor, God will be with you in trouble. Won't he do it? I said, won't he do it? Jump up and say yeah. Jump up and say yeah. Clap your hands and say yeah. Oh, yes. He'll be with you. When you go through the flood, it won't overtake you. When you go through the fire, it won't burn you. Tell your neighbor, hang in there. Tell somebody, hang in there. Tell them, I know you got trouble. Come on, you got situations. Tell them, but whatever you do, don't bow to your situation. Tell them, say, neighbor, you may bend, but don't bow. Shout yeah. Clap your hands and say yeah. Oh, yeah. Clap your hands. I don't hear nothing. I don't hear nothing. I don't hear nothing. don't hear nothing. Say, neighbor, whatever you do, don't buy. He said, I looked in there. Then we put in three. But there's another one in there. Look like. Look like the Son of God. And not only was he in there with them, but they were walking around loose. No, they said. Remember when they put them in there, they were bound. But when you saw them the next day, they were loose. Tell somebody, God will loose you if you just don't buy. God have mercy if you just don't buy. I don't care what you're going through in your life right now. I don't care what you're dealing with now. I don't care what you had to deal with before you got here today. I don't care what you're dealing with on the job. What you're dealing with in the marriage. What you're dealing with at home. What you're dealing with in your family. Whatever you do, don't give in. Don't throw in the towel. Don't bow because you look like you're outnumbered. But greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. Don't give up the ship. Tell somebody, don't give up the ship. Hallelujah. All folks say, don't throw the baby out with the bad water. Don't give up the ship. You mean they got rid of a good man? You mean they got rid of a good woman? Come on. And guess what? There's somebody right there waiting on. Say, come on, baby. As soon as you throw over that woman right there, say, come on, I've been waiting on her to get rid of you. And you be the Mr. Good Man. You be the Mr. Good Woman. You be the Mr. Good Position on the job. Because you let them devils on the job get on your last nerve. And you end up cussing everybody out and got fired.
My Lord.
You bow. You bow to what they were doing to you. And Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego said, throw us in there. We're going to take it before we get in there. Our God is able. He said, and even if he don't deliver us, that don't mean he ain't able. One of the books of the Bible said, they went in the furnace singing. They ain't got it. They went in the furnace singing. Furnace represent affliction. Furnace represent trials. Furnace represent a situation. They went in the situation singing. I don't know what they were saying, but if I would have been there, they probably was saying, I know the Lord
will make a way
somehow. I don't know. Maybe they went in there saying, I got a feeling
everything
that everything
is going to
be all right. I don't know. Maybe they went in there saying, this little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. Maybe they went in there saying, glory, glory.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Since I laid my burden down. Let me throw this in and I won't charge you for it. It's not how you look when you go through, but it's how you look when you come out.
Amen.
And I'm a firm believer that God won't let you look like
what
you've been through.
Amen.
I add even more to that. God won't even let you look your age.
Amen. Thank you, Lord.
You may be kicking 60 in the back.
Stepping on his head.
God will let you look like the 35.
Yeah.
You may be 90, not 90, but 90. And God will let you walk in stiletto with a straight back. Y'all think I'm joking? David said he knows how to preserve. I keep telling y'all there's a difference between being canned, pickled, and preserved. God ain't gonna can me. God ain't gonna pickle me. But God's going to preserve me. I keep telling the mother, Sadie, I want to look as good as I look now at 80.
Amen.
As good as I look now, I want to look like that at 80 years old. And going on in Jesus' name. But I need to know he'll preserve me. He'll keep you. He'll condition you. Didn't I preach condition for the condition? He'll condition you for the conditions that come up in your life. And wherever it makes folk look like they've been through hell, you won't look like you've been through nothing. You had six kids? Yeah. And all of them grown? Child, you lying. So yeah, I had six.
Ain't got no stomach, no stretch marks.
That's right. That's right.
Come on now, God will preserve you. Then you can have a woman that had one baby look like she had 20.
Amen.
Look at somebody and say, ay, 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 ay. Don't you let your situations make you give in. Did y'all get what I was trying to preach? Don't bow to your situation. You're going to have them. Life is full of them. But don't let your situations make you bitter. Don't let your situation make you evil. Make you wicked. Don't let your situations steal your joy. But you ain't got no joy no more. Because you're going from, the old folks said, from pillar to post. You're going from one extreme to the other. And you showing it. Everybody can see it on your face. You ain't even open your mouth. Let me tell you something. You ain't got to open your mouth. People today can just look at you. Who enjoying what I'm trying to preach? Come on, don't lie to me. People today can just look at you. And they can tell. They can tell, oh, oh, she going through hell. How you know? Look how they looking. Smile all jacked up.
Huh?
Clothes all jacked up. If Pastor Mitchell going through, y'all will never know it.
Never know. Come on, Pastor, that's right.
Because I'm going to come in here and smile with the teeth I got left.
All right.
And grin and laugh, and I may be going through hell and high water. Mama said if I was hungry, I wouldn't tell you. In other words, don't let the devil know he's getting the best of you. If he's getting the best of you, won't nobody know it until you tell it. Brother Deacon, that's just like if you go down there to the thrift store and you buy a suit, ain't nobody got to know you bought it from the thrift store unless you tell them.
Amen.
Because you got some folk in the shop at the thrift store and make it look like $1 million.
That's right.
Go to Walmart and get a $60 outfit, make it look like something out of Saks Fifth Avenue. Until you open your big mouth. Well, you know, I really got it from the dollar store. Look at somebody and say, don't tell nobody. Your secrets. Your secret is safe with me. Like Clinton, they ain't never heard that song before. Don't tell nobody. Keep it to yourself. When the Lord bless you. Don't let that situation get the best of you. Come on, say amen.
Amen.
Come on, Brother Deacons. I need y'all, Brother Deacons. Please.
Amen.
Don't let your situation get the best of you.
Yes, amen.
Because you're going to have them. But ain't nobody got to know you got them unless you open your mouth.
Amen.
Chadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in my conclusion. They said, you're going to throw us in there. But we're going to tell you before you put us in there.
Amen.
We still ain't going to bow.
Amen.
Amen.
Defiant. Tell somebody defiant.
Defiant.
You gotta be defiant.
Defiant.
Nope. Let me say this to you. And we got some food back there. I can't wait to get it in. But listen to this. How many of y'all ever remember Emmett Till? Some of y'all may be too young. Emmett Till. Mm-hmm. He went to a little place called Money, Mississippi. And he was killed because they said he whistled at a white woman. Come to find out, the boy had a speech impediment. He was 14 years old, but he was husky. Y'all call him fat now, but back in the day, he was a husky boy. He was husky. And the men came into his uncle's house, who was a preacher, got him up out the bed, took him and beat him. He was from Chicago, but his home was Money, Mississippi. Home was Chicago, but his relatives were from Money, Mississippi. They beat that boy. And they beat him, but he wouldn't cry.
Amen.
And the white man said, oh, this nigga ain't gonna cry.
That's right.
That was what was on record. Because he was tough. And they beat him, but he would not cry. You know what really killed him? They took a fan, an industrial fan blade, wrapped it around his neck, threw him into the Mississippi River. That's what killed him. Not them beating him, but drowning from that man. Why are you telling us that story, Pastor Mitchell? For this one word, he was defiant.
Amen.
He said, y'all may kill me, but it ain't going to be from me crying. I'm not going to cry. And to be 14 years old, he died like a man.
Amen.
Because he refused to cry. First natural, then spiritual. On the spiritual side, we as Christians ought to have a defiant spirit.
Amen. Amen.
That no matter what the devil do to me, I won't let go.
Nope.
I won't give up.
Thank you, Lord.
I won't give in. The words of that song said, I believe in the Father and His Son.
Yes, Lord.
Got my religion when I was very young. Things I have to suffer bring tears to my eyes.
Yes.
Enemies inflicting all the hurt he can, throwing his rocks and hiding their hands.
Yes, Lord.
But I won't let go.
Nope.
I won't let go.
Nope.
I won't let go. Let me see the hands in here that won't let go. I won't let go. Do what you will to me, devil. But I won't let go.
Thank you,
Lord. I may have to die. What the old Negro saying, I'd rather be buried in my grave than to be a slave and go home with my Lord.
Amen.
And be free. There were some people in the slavery times, they knew they were going to die. Because they said, we ain't bowing to the white man. Kill me. And they killed them. Because some of them couldn't see themselves being no slave. You might well go ahead, Master, you might well go ahead and kill me. Because I ain't raising your babies. I ain't taking out your swap. And you treat me lower than a cow. And many of them sleeping, as old folks said, beneath the cloud. Because they refuse to give in. Everyone standing all over the place. As we open the doors of church.